Inside the conference chamber, already at the table, Mr. Pham Dang Lam from South Vietnam. In over 150 such meetings, what have they achieved? This week, ECHO re-examines the prospects for peace in Vietnam.
A companion peace demonstration brings out 50,000 marchers in downtown San Francisco. They parade 2 miles along Market Street, pacifists and hippies together. Gigantic Kesar Stadium holds the mass rally, where anti-war songs and speeches trigger a short scuffle between pro and con factions. No one was injured. Both demonstrations were sponsored by a loose coalition of left-wing, pacifist and moderate anti-war groups. President Johnson, meanwhile, let it be known that the FBI is closely watching all anti-war activity. In Rome, a peace demonstration ironically erupts into violence near the U.S. Embassy along the glamorous Via Veneto. Police, alerted to possible trouble, stopped the marchers just short of their goal, and then the march turned into a riot. Anti-war demonstrators protest U.S. involvement in the Vietnam War in mass marches, rallies, and demonstrations. Central Park is the starting point for the parade to the UN building. The estimated 125,000 Manhattan marchers include students, housewives, beatnik poets, doctors, businessmen, teachers, priests, and nuns. Makeup and costumes were bizarre. Before the parade, mass draft card burning was urged. Demonstrators claimed 200 cards were burned, but no accurate count could be determined. Reporters and onlookers were jostled away on purpose. Although mostly peaceful, shouted confrontations were frequent and fiery during the course of the march. The anti-war marchers were picketed by anti-anti-war marchers who were hawkish toward the parading doves. Civil rights leader Martin Luther King leads the procession to the United Nations, where he urges UN pressure to force the U.S. to stop bombing North Vietnam.